Our airfield has been overrun by Japanese troops. Miller, call the rednecks. It's one of the most badass Marines I've ever seen. Shoot! Our comrades have been shot! Roxy, what do we do?
You wanna know what I think? I think you have both.
Nathan Drake over here today, back again with another video. And in this video, yes guys, it is here. I announced it in my last video that I will be doing a Call of Duty World at War review. And yeah guys, here it is.
After I did my last review on Call of Duty Modern Warfare 4, I knew that I still had some ground to cover till the next Call of Duty game. World at War innovated in so many ways from COD 4 that it even makes Fortnite look like a dumbass. Now you see, Call of Duty World at War took a risk by going back to the World War II setting. It innovated by giving us new perks like the Double Tap Root Beer and Quick Revive perk, while keeping the same perks like Juggernaut and Speed Cola perks from the last game, Call of Duty Modern Warfare 4. We even got to see four sides of World War II, giving it a lot of historical value, and also a huge arsenal of weapons, which was really good for the players in the multiplayer because they never got bored of the weapons they were using. It actually gave us innovation. You see, the reason why we think the newer Call of Duty suck balls is because they never give us any of this innovation at all from year to year.
You know, there was this one day where Treyarch was looking at Infinity War and saw how well they were doing with Modern Warfare 4. They saw there was this new Spec Ops mode that came out that guaranteed their huge success with a lot of replayability value in the game. And you might ask the question yourself, what was Treyarch's answer to the Spec Ops mode? Well, I'm glad you asked.
You see, in 2008, people said, fuck Spec Ops mode. This is the real thing. Nazi zombies single-handedly changed the whole Call of Duty series as a whole that it's been going on for over 10 years now at this point.
You know, after all the things that Call of Duty World at War did, I gotta say, it's one of the best games in the series. It was such a step forward that it even makes their last game look like a piece of garbage. Which it is.